Women's qualifications, and all eyes were on her last year's World Cup winner, Ben Gange, would do. She rode well in qualifications, securing second highest score of the day and a place in the final six, along with high scorer and top seed Ray Murray. Australian Amber Wynne was back on the water after last year's injury had left her sidelined, and America's Melissa Marquardt's strong qualifications ride had secured her place. Britain's Nicola Butler and Swede Caroline Jupso were last to gain their spots after dropping beneath the initial cut, having to ride it out in the last chance qualifier. Australian riders Caitlin Aristabel-Adell and Chloe Mills fell just below the LCQ cut, joining Larissa Morales, Megan Barker, Giorgio Gregoria and Han Key on the sidelines to cheer the others on.
We have so many good riders here, Nicola Butler, Amber Wing, Melissa Marquardt. So it's awesome to see, you know, all these awesome riders come from everywhere, all over the world, and to be able to compete against them is awesome.
Everyone that's here, basically everyone in the contest list, is just awesome. So I don't know, I'm just happy to, yeah, hopefully I'll do good, stick my best.
That Gange won here in Mandurah last year, so I didn't have the best ride, and everyone kind of expected me to win, so it was, you know, I was kind of upset about it, so I'm kind of coming back here to hopefully take the win. I broke my ankle back in June, and I was in and out of a cast, and so I ended up getting surgery on it. I'm still not 100%, but, you know, I came here to win just like everybody else, so we'll see how it goes.
It feels awesome to be back, ready for another year after two successful ones.
So does it all feel a bit unreal still?
Yeah, a little bit. Can't believe it's been a whole year and we're back here already, but I'm excited for it.
We now join Matt Crowhurst as we head dockside for the IWWF Women's Wakeboard Final.
We are rounding off the third year of this Wakeboard and Water Ski World Cup, courtesy of IWWF, present at the Mandurah Action Sports Games. And we are into the ladies' finals with the first of our ladies on the water right now, Nicola Butler, charging at that wake on her heel side edge for a big old tantrum. Going for an indie tantrum, that is a backhand grab on the toe side edge of the board. Looked like it might have just missed that grab though. Comes back at the wake on her toe side edge, looking a little bit wobbly for Nicola. Usually one of the smoother riders out there on the ladies' circuit. Incredible style, a whole bunch of tricks under her belt, but looking to go at this very first run in a very, very smooth style so far, not really pushing it that hard at all. So we've seen the tantrum, we've seen the scarecrow, frontside 360, and then the front roll onto the rail, just making sure she mixes those composition points. The judges want to be seeing a good variety of all aspects of the sport from each of our riders. The most well-rounded rider, the most smooth riding will win out. So she came away from that first pass cleanly, came off the rail a little bit early on the way down, comes off the rail a little bit later on the way back for a backside board slide to 90 out. Then she comes back at the wake, left foot forward, which is switched for her for a half cab 180 and a little grab. A setup trick, ready for her to attack this wake on her heel side once again. The Mastercraft X-Star, as always, kicking up a huge wake for these contests for every single World Cup stop event across the world. But on that particular occasion, perhaps the chop getting the better of the wake as Nicola came in. She chose not to hit the wake, to take it a little bit easier, and was perhaps thinking about something else, as that is the second scarecrow we've seen from her in her two passes. And that is her two runs done. This is the final. She is the first lady out of the dock. That is the level at which the rest of the ladies have to be aiming at. Moving on to our second ladies rider, now moving back to Europe. It is Caroline Jupso of Sweden. A regular fixture at the World Cup events, a regular fixture on the world scene of ladies wakeboarding, and looking very comfortable on that very first trick. Huge back roll, monumental air, as she sets herself up for a third trick now on this very first pass in her finals run. Toe side front roll, and already getting much more amplitude than we saw from Nicola Butler. It seems as though Caroline is just charging that wake a little bit harder. And there we see an example of the bit between her teeth in the form of that whirly bird. A huge, huge, big maneuver that is going to get a few of the ladies on the dock perhaps a little bit worried. Then straight in to the backside lip slide on the rail to round up her first pass. And that's an incredible run from the Swedish girl, mixing it up with the rest of the world. So in this final of the ladies, we have the USA represented three times, Australia twice, and just one young lady from Sweden. That's Caroline, who's out on the water now, looking very comfortable indeed. Now on this particular setup, we are running through an estuary, so the water is never as calm as it could possibly be on a lake, but the conditions looking pretty good for our riders in this final. But that has not helped Caroline right there on an air rally, a signature trick of wakeboarding, and I would imagine a staple maneuver for her, not one that she would fall on usually, so a little bit of a reprieve for the rest of the girls on the dock as Caroline tries to squeeze in some more maneuvers but doesn't manage to in the second half of that second pass, and she is going to have to rely on that stellar first run to get her a place on the podium. It is the USA, represented by Melissa Marquette, out on the water next in this ladies' final of the IWWF Wakeboard World Cup in Mandurah at the Action Sports Games. We're just an hour north of Perth in this whole western province of Australia, one of the wealthiest and most beautiful coastlines that the country has to offer. So it's incredible to be back here for the third year running, and hopefully for many more years to come. We join Melissa a couple of tricks in, wrapped up. Oh, nicely done. Oh, that is one of the more technical maneuvers we've seen from the girls, and not a particular trick that we've seen from any of them so far. A toe side back roll with a backside 180, wrapping up to make it happen, but unfortunately just going a little bit too big. Melissa also famed for being rather comfortable on the rails, as we saw from that very final maneuver in that first pass. A backside lip slide, popping right onto the horizontal of the rail, then doing the same again the other way, but a frontside lip slide all the way to the end, setting her up perfectly for the rest of this second pass to follow. There we get the sky view of Melissa in action, flying across those wakes on a heelside grab maneuver. Back of the wake on a toe side edge now. What's it going to be? She probably needs to be up in the technical stakes, which she does, with a toe side roll to revert, getting a little melon grab in there as well, but not getting the height she needed to clear that second wake and taking a little bit of a casing as she landed. So that will be her second fall. That is her done. And we move on to the next rider. We see the air Rayleigh from Miss Amber Wing. That was what saw Caroline take a fall. Not for Amber, though. And Amber, obviously, local girl to Australia. There is going to be a lot of support for this young lady. Just the first of our two Australians in this ladies' final. Going big, going smooth, getting a good grab in on that frontside 360. Now back at the weights on her toe side edge. We know that Amber has a lot of technical maneuvers, but perhaps this first run is just going to be to get some scores on the board. Frontside lip slide, pretty comfortable. Getting pulled off the rail a little bit earlier than the end, but still a very solid first run indeed from Amber. Now, as with all the riders, she's going to be attacking the rail once again to start off the second pass of her run, the final pass, getting a little bit of a casing as she gets launched off the incline, managing to suck it up and ride it all the way to the end. Now in on a toe side edge, Scarecrow landing cleanly, hops it back round to right foot forward, which is a more comfortable way of riding, coming back heel side now for a big maneuver. Oh, and she gets swallowed whole by the meaty wake of the Mastercraft X Star. It is her first fall, so she will get picked up again. That was the Moby Dick. Is she going to go for it again? She possibly needs to if she's going to lock the door on the other riders. There's the Indy Tantrum. So manages to get another invert and not the technically high scoring one that she was perhaps after, but still some solid riding from Amber. Now, as you look at all the runs that we've seen so far, it's looking very, very close, making our judges' job extremely difficult. Moving on to the penultimate rider in this ladies' final now, and is Bec Ganj, the winner from last year, who is not going to claim that top spot again, taking a fall on her first trick. She will have a lot of work to do. I say she's not going to claim the top spot. Obviously, that is nowhere written at the moment, but she is definitely piling the pressure on by having an early fall. Takes the bull by the horns, though, and throws that back roll once again, the trick she fell on at the start of her run. There's the Scarecrow. Toe side front roll with a front side 360 with a little bit of a butt drop, which will not help her overall composition points. I think a bit of a signal to the boat driver to potentially slow the boat down a little bit. Then she will be able to land down the transition of the wake as opposed to way out into the flats. Coming back to the rail on her second pass. Frontside lip slide. We've seen similar things from the girls so far on the rails, all looking very comfortable at that stage. Now what can she come up with in this second pass that will help her close the gap on the rest of the riders who have already been, and perhaps shut the door on that lady, Raimi Merritt, who is waiting to go. Toe side now, nice cruisy edge, toe side 540, cleanly done. That's exactly the sort of things that we need to be seeing from Beck if she's going to recapture that title or even get on the podium spot. It's going to be tough. Heel side 3 going absolutely huge, running out of room now on this second pass as she stays wide of the X-Star for perhaps one more trick. It is a toe side front roll and a little bit of a butt drop, and not the cleanest riding from Beck at all, which is really unfortunate for the girl who took the title. The reigning champion from 2013 is not going to retain that title, but who is going to take the title? So far, it is looking very close between the likes of Nicola, Caroline, and Amber. Beck and Melissa not having the best of runs, so it's now perhaps left the door a little bit open for Raimi Merritt, who, of all the riders you want stuck on the dock, waiting to go, you do not want to give her any breathing space whatsoever, as this girl has taken every single title there is on the world wakeboarding stage. Huge air ready to get things going. Toe side front roll to follow up. Cruises back in, hard on the heel side edge. Nose grab, heel side, front side 360, no butt checking. No sloppy maneuvers, no touching of that water. It's looking incredibly tight so far. Toe side now, off axis 540, off a toe side edge, spinning front side and making that handle pass happen while the board goes off axis behind her. Now it's just the rail between her and the end of this first pass. Cleanly done, solid riding as you come to expect from Raimi. Now in comparing the ladies' runs so far, the first passes for each of them, I would say that that is definitely one of the smoothest. Is there enough technicality in there though? We will have to wait and see whether she's got any more of that kind of riding in the bank for this second pass to close the door on the rest of the ladies. And that is exactly what we're needing to see. A backside 270 rewind off the rail, now coming in on a toe side edge. Bit of a grab, a setup maneuver, but not going for what she wanted and needing some more speed from the boat. She needs a clean wake as she's attacking it, and it isn't a clean wake at all. Crushing water over the top of the binding, stopping that board dead, pitching her over the front and not getting enough amplitude and just causing a dead sailor altogether. And that is the end of the run for Raimi Merritt. Will that be enough? Such tight riding, such great riding from all the girls, and a tough decision for our judges.
America's Raimi Merritt leading the way once again on 62.33 points. Britain's Nicola Butler second on 60.11. And Caroline Jupsai from Sweden third with 55.32 points.
Yeah, I'm so excited to be back in Mandurah, and to have another win under my belt is just awesome. I didn't have the best run, you know. My second pass kind of fell apart a little bit. I'm happy to be on top.
Raimi Merritt!
And there's more still to come from Mandurah. Join us after the break for coverage of the men's finals.